Students, welcome to my channel Agricultural Engineering Online. With continuation of the solution of the question paper GATE 2018, this is question number 46 under the section of irrigation and drainage. This is about furrow irrigation. The question says furrows of 120 meter length with 0.5% slope are made at 90 centimeter spacing. The maximum non-erosive steep flow that is applied in a furrow that takes 1 hour to reach the lower end. Then this flow rate is reduced to half of its size and subsequently continued for another 1 hour. The average depth of applied water is 10 cm. This is a straightforward question where the furrow irrigation is done with a maximum non-erosive stream flow initially, flow rate, and subsequently it is irrigated for 1 hour, then its stream size is reduced to half. Let us try to solve quickly. So, furrow irrigation is one type of method of irrigating water. So, open irrigation, where actually the furrows are made inside the in between the furrows, the water is actually irrigated up to certain depth. Then, actually, the crops are grown in the actually this ridge, or you can say furrow. These are the furrows actually. So the furrows are actually irrigated with a main channel, and there is a sub channel actually. And this in these ridges, this is the different type of plains or furrows actually. These are irrigated actually from this. These are irrigated. These are the irrigated water. So at a given slope, the slope of the furrows are given 0.5 for the main stream. Basically, for non-erosive, so no erosion should be there when there will be maximum stream or you can say discharge of the channel should be there. Therefore, at a given slope, which is S, in percentage is 0.5 is given. Maximum non-erosive flow rate. There is a empirical formula for that actually, so which is called the QM. QM is called the maximum non-erosive flow rate in liter per second unit, and that will be equal to 0.6 by S. S is the slope in percentage. In this case, the slope is given as 0.5, therefore the non-erosive flow rate will be equal to 0.6 by 0.5, that is 1.2 liter per second. So once you know the non-erosive flow rate or stream rate, then we can use the average depth of water applied during an irrigation. Generally, when the water is irrigated, so it is saying that 1 hour is required to reach the end of the furrow. Therefore, the one hour, what are the depth of irrigated water? So that will be equal to Q into D is Q into 360 into T by W into L, where is D is the depth of applied water in centimeter, Q is the maximum discharge or full flow rate in liter per second, and 360 is for hour, and T is in 1 hour. T is in hour or time in hour, and divided by W is the width of the furrow in meter, and L is the length of the furrow in meter, which is given. Q is 1.2 liter per second, T is 1 hour for first hour, and W is 0.9 meter, and L is 120 meter. So that's why first 1 hour depth of applied water is equal to D1, that is multiplying 1.2 into 360 into 1 divided by 0.9 into 120, that is 4 centimeter. So in the first hour of irrigation, 4 centimeter of water is applied in the furrow. So next, the stream is made into half or reduced to half, and again it's irrigated for another 1 hour. Therefore, in the second hour, depth applied water with half flow rate, which is 1.2 initial flow rate or non-erosive maximum flow rate divided to, that is 0.6 liter per second. So applying this again into the second hour of depth of water application, that will be instead of 1.2, 0.6 is applied. So if you see 1.2 is becoming 0.6, and the others are same because the next is 1 hour, 360 and 1 is same, and 0.9 and 1 to same. So there will be the water again irrigated is 2 cm. Therefore, the total depth of irrigation will be equal to D1 plus D2, that is 4 plus 2 is equal to 6 cm. Therefore, the total depth of application of water, irrigation water, is equal to 6 cm. So this is the answer for this question. Hope you understand. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel.